Hi, I'm Royston, and let me take you on a tour to rediscover the neighbourhood of Balestier. So as a filmmaker, I enjoy coming to Balestier because of the, you know, the juxtaposition of old and new buildings. It creates like a visual conflict, and that is something very, very interesting for me. That's why like a lot of my film production, like the old places and old romantic series, they're all done here. So this is something that I really, really like. So this is my favourite hangout, Long Fa Tau Sa Piah. And this place is developed in 1948. And back in the 1970s, this is where they invent the Long Fa Tau Sa Piah. And what's so special about this Long Fa Tau Sa Piah is actually they incorporate the Western way of making pastry together with traditional way of making Tau Sa Piah. So when you put this in your mouth, right? The taste is almost like, you know, 外脆内滑. You know, just create this euphoria combustion inside your mouth, and that's something I really, really, really like. And also, look at the partition over here. It really reminded me of Wong Kar Wai's film, and it's a few of the remaining places you actually see this. So this place is run by the third generation already. So this is Mr. Lee over here. I'm kind of a little nuisance to him because sometimes I order a lot of Tau Sa Piah for him. So yeah, Mr. Lee, give me today's special 200克啦哈.
Wow, how long have you been? You're still the same.
Wow,
really happy. Every time I come here, I feel like I'm the elected MP for this area. So, yeah, it's wonderful. And this place has been around since the 1960s. As you can see, the design here hasn't changed much. Look at the font and everything. It's something that I'm really very, very excited about. And this is the place where I actually shot old romances. So, allow me to introduce you the second generation owners. Hello, 老板娘. 哇，怎么没有老道啊？ 还是这么好看。 So walking out here, you are greeted by this, you know, coffee aroma. And this is the Lamyo coffee powder, and it's an old school coffee roaster.
So right now we are at the Wu Cao Tua Pek Kong Temple. It's set up in the 1800s by the Hokkien immigrants and labourers. So what really attracts me to this place is that, you know, you rarely you do see a temple that's like totally red in colour. And this place reminds me of the old buildings that you see like the Siheyuan in the Hokkien province and even in the older part of Taiwan. So it has a bit of an overseas heritage actually, still preserved very well in Singapore. There's a myth that if you ever dream of snakes, then you need to come to this temple to make an offering for safety and also to say thank you to the deity. Within this temple, there's this wayang stage, which is over 100 years old already. If I'm not wrong, this is the last few remaining wayang stage in Singapore. Before the COVID time, you know, there's Teochew Opera and Hokkien Opera actually performing here. And in fact, this place is actually the storage place for the famous Singapore Hokkien troupe, Sing Sai Fong. So let me bring you backstage to have a look at this place. So one of the fun facts about Hokkien Opera is a lot of times it's not scripted, it's all improv. So you just need to know the base storyline, and after that, the actors will take it upon themselves to deliver their way of performance. So to me, this is a very, very interesting way because, you know, you might have one script, but 1,000 other kinds of deliveries. One of these numbers is going to strike 40. So right now we are in Sun Yat-sen Nanyang Memorial Hall, also known as Wan Qing Yuan. So this is also the base for his Tong Men Hui. So this place chronicles the events leading to the 1911 revolution. So let's take a look around. In 2011, when this place was revamped and opened, I was very honoured to be the creative director for their cultural fest. And this is the place where we converted it as a stage for Chinese opera.
I'm always intrigued by our Chinese culture heritage, especially the Singapore ones, because I think there's only so much you can learn from textbook. A lot of times it's always diluted. I'm always very curious to find out more about what my forefathers have actually gone through. And every time when I come here, it's a brand new discovery.
Hello, 老板, B, 你好. 好久不见. 哎, 我的鱼头炉啊。 哇,猪脚来了。 Right now, we are at Wang Po Makan Place, and as you can see right now, it's really very quiet. There's not a lot of people, but the whole place will be filled up in 40 minutes because of one particular store. And it's over there, which is the Xing Heng Feng Guo Tiao Tang. And their specialties is actually this Yu Tou Lu. So what's very interesting about this is they actually use charcoal. So it's very old school, you know, it reminded me of how I had steamboat back in the 80s. So apart from the charcoal Yu Tou Lu, it also comes with many other authentic Teochew dishes like Lu Dan, Xian Cai, and my favorite, Tau Guan. You know, this place sells Yu Tou Lu, right? But you might ask me, like, why is this store called Xing Heng Feng Guo Tiao Dian? Because in the daytime, they sell guo tiao mian, and nighttime, they sell this yu tou lu. I always like to bring people from overseas, like my friends from Taiwan, to come and try this dish, because in Taiwan, their dish are all influenced by Fujian. But this is from Caozhou, so I think the taste of it is actually very, very different. And I think culture, a lot of times, can be experienced through food. Thank you for taking this tour of Balestier with me, and I hope to see you soon. Okay, I cannot wait already. I have to start eating.